Marius, Andre, and Christina, welcome. It's a day after the competition, and what are your thoughts on the new final format which you were dancing yesterday?
Well, actually, it was nice to have such a stamina-less or stamina-free final, because it was a lot of breaking between the dances for us, which of course probably makes us think more about the details and about the artistry of it, and not so much about you have to go, you have to go, you still have to go. Your pulse can go low, you know, so you can enter in every dance very, very free, you know. This was quite a nice experience.
Yeah, we enjoy really much, and I also said yesterday we felt less stress as well between the couples somehow. I don't know, everybody were relaxed. I don't know if it's connected with the system or because it was the last competition for us, but probably because of the system, because we had it also in Singapore.
The last competition of the year.
Of the year.
The people can
interpret. Yeah. Because we had it also in the Singapore, and it was the same feeling for us. So I think it's a nice feeling for the dancers, and I heard also the audience were happy about that.
What do you do between dances? I was watching you behind the scene or backstage when you were just like cleaning your shoes or doing something. What do you do and what do you think during those few minutes which you have between dances?
Generally, I go through the choreography, through the next dance in the head. This is what I am doing. So if I can do a joke with somebody, it's also nice for me. Gives me positive energy. So generally, I'm trying to have a nice time and to go in the head the next choreography, so the next dances. Yeah. Also for the fact that you don't know what the music will gonna be. So you create your own music, you create your own rhythm inside of the head. I mean, you don't go through the steps really, because you don't think on the steps. But you create yourself that energy, what you had in the rehearsals before home. So this is the thing. And I don't know, I think everybody should concentrate to this, what gives him positive energy. And it might be different. People maybe should think how to kill somebody. You know, I'm joking. But if this gives him good energy, you know, to dance, then why not? I mean,
I'm just making sure that everything is prepared for the next dance, like brush my shoes. I had yesterday the tail, so I needed all the time to brush it, you know. And if I have long break, as we had between Rumba and Paso Doble, we were first in Rumba in first hit and third in Paso, so we have quite long break. So I tried to sit as well to have a bit legs relaxed. So it was a lot of Chinese on the angle sitting there, and there was one place and I was sitting between them. They was watching me, because I think they were like normal people not connecting with the dancing, so yeah. They was like watching to me, and I had such a short skirt, they was always watching to me, and I saw the phones also on the hands. So I was like watching, I was like, are they making pictures to me or what?
Yeah, they were like probably people, bodyguards or
yeah,
something,
like,
from the
so they
security,
see us with
you know?
All that makeup and everything,
and then there was no place near her, and one time I wanted also to sit down, and there was one guy, and I say, can I sit down? And he didn't really get there. Come on, I need the place, I'm dancing now. but was okay. Then there was the place. Could have been more chairs in the competitions. This is a thing which, I mean, you know, these small details. Could have been more chairs. Generally, the chairs are good. People are fighting for chairs in the backstage. The public doesn't really get that, because generally in the public are a lot of chairs. Yes, but in the background, sometimes a lot of chairs is not bad, because we are all fighting for the chairs. And this is the moment, you know, is that moment when you really want to sit down, is that moment when you feel, and somehow you are in the middle of the competition and you don't really want to think now, will I gonna get a chair or something? So this was yesterday probably one thing which could be better, but
Christina, you mentioned about it that you had a ponytail yesterday, yeah. And I've seen you changing styles like almost in every competition. How do you decide your style in each competition?
Yeah, I have the feeling now I'm a little bit more calm with that. I'm not that crazy anymore. Yeah, I have just, I'm bored with something just always keeping same about the look. Yeah, and sometimes having few comps and I think that something need to be changed. So it's just my inner feeling somehow, I don't know. Now I'm keeping like that. It can be tail or more closed hair, but I think this rolling hair, I will keep that. I think it's passing to me, I like it how it looks, so.
And I'm very supportive with all of this. Very supportive.
Everything goes.
Sometimes I don't even know what it's coming next. And then in the morning I wake up and... fantastic.
Yeah, also, you know...
But you know, sometimes I see another color. Completely. But I like everything on her, I have to say. It's just that I'm getting surprised. But this surprised feeling has to be directly positive towards a woman, generally. Because if it goes a bit, then it's done. The competition is done before it started. So.
But it's a lot about my feeling and me, you know? Like, I don't care so much about people feedback in a way, because I already received from yesterday, some of them were saying it was great, some of them were saying that it was not good. So doesn't matter what I will gonna do, there will be people like it and people not like it. So it's about me. If I feel good in that, then it's good.
Okay. In the beginning of the season, you mentioned Cuba. But how have their influences remained during this season from Cuba?
I think good.
Yeah.
I
think it's always need to be refreshed somehow, because the moment you come back from there, you really have it. Then with the time, you're a little bit losing because we are living not in Cuba. So you lose a bit that feeling. But still, we try to have it in the mind, in the blood, in the moment. It's harder to have it, because if you don't have that, but still, you know, you have this internet and Facebook and Instagram. I always following that Cuban pages and always watching them dancing. So always inspired from them.
But we will go soon again there, for sure. Yeah. One more thing, we have a show also. Yeah, when we are dancing our shows around the world, it's a Cuban tema, you know, on the show. So it's like every time refreshing, because... somehow when we are dancing actually a samba, yeah, but then when I'm in that mood is different than in the competition mood, so it's every time refreshment. And we did this show also, for example, last week on Saturday, and I felt again a refreshment on that. It's a nice feeling. But it's also given a lot from the music, I have to say. If the music is good, it's easy. If the music is not so good, heavier.
Speaking about shows, you had a little show yesterday too at the presentation dances. How did you choose your partners who to dance it with, and who chose the music and choreography and everything?
Actually, we had to choose the couple like very fast. We didn't have an opportunity before, really. So we chose Charles and Elena, which was a great idea. And Then Christina had this idea of making a dance which is very in the moment in China, you
popular,
know?
Popular, yeah.
Popular.
Yeah.
So they
so
have
So we have some friends.
We have some Chinese
what
friends.
What is now, you know, people going for? And they sent me a few.
Yeah, we asked the most famous English song in China, which was reggaeton, which we like very much because it's like generally from South America.
And Beyonce also singing that song.
So yes.
He's passing.
And the Chinese one you saw. The Chinese dance.
And when I was dancing, you know, I was turning around and I was watching people were also doing that. I was like, oh, very good. If I will forget, I can watch them.
Yeah.
That's really nice. And now it's the end of the season for you. Did I understand right?
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah.
And what are your plans for holiday? Do you take time off from dancing, or how are you going to spend the holiday season?
Yeah, we actually talked about it yesterday in the interview after the final. We were going to have a break, and we said it yesterday. I will repeat it one more time. It's very important for the couples to have several times in the year short breaks. It's important for body and also for mind that you know that you end up part of the season and you will going to start again. And we have 2-3 times a year, 6 to 7 days of break, like longer. And this is one of this this time now we're gonna be. We generally like summer holidays, so we were gonna try to have sun.
We like also winter, but we cannot, because if we go to ski or something,
yes,
it's dangerous. Yeah, so it's better to stay on the sun doing nothing.
Yeah, this is the thing about the dancer. You know, you don't ski, I don't ski. Just make it simple. You play club sports. Billiard, darts, bowling. You have to be careful with your time because if
our
you're
fingers.
Going, you know. So you go club sports, but winter sports, it's a bit, you know. I don't do that.
You don't want to risk your career as a dancer.
And the problem is with, for example, with football. Yeah, I love football, and when I see the ball, I want to play.
Yeah, and it's so funny because he plays very good football, and sometimes he's coming to the new team who doesn't know how he's playing. So he say, "Guys, but easy, please, easy." They say, "Oh, come on, you're so big, like, man, and easy." And he say, "Yeah, please, I'm a dancer, easy." Then they start to play and like really good, and they say, "But why you say easy?" Say, "Yeah, I mean not to kick my legs, you know, but I can play good, man."
Yeah, when we go on holiday, basically, you know, you meet some people in the holiday there, in some resort, and then you play together with them, and they say, "Easy, don't touch me, easy."
But that's really something to for your fans to hear too, that you really need to take a break twice a year at least, and then be careful about what you do so that you don't risk your dancer's career.
About this, I would like to say something. It was actually this year in the World Championship Latin. Now I can speak openly about it. Before I couldn't. I was dancing with a very big injury on my
thigh,
inside edge of the thigh. So, yeah, it happened because of a lot of competitions in a very short time. And you just get burnt. The body gets burned and you don't even realize it anymore because your stamina is so good that you don't feel tired anymore. When you are in a period of, like, for example, 2-3 months of high preparation, you don't feel tired. And this is the moment when your muscle, you get all these vitamins, minerals. We have all this kind of stuff. You have the injections, you have all these things. We are fully equipped. But still, if you do a lot, you get burnt. This is the thing. And then I had this injury just several days before the Worlds. And of course, in the Worlds, we didn't attend the opening ceremony. It was on Ostrava, nice place, great place, but there is still ice underneath. So for example, my doctor say, "Don't go to the opening ceremony." But I didn't tell this to nobody. Couldn't talk about it. I mean, I don't want to tell to somebody, you know, I'm injured.
And he needed all the time to warm up.
And
really
I needed to warm up
before
every round. I needed
and
to
normally
warm up.
After that.
After the last round, before the opening ceremony, there was a very short break. Opening ceremony and dancing, because they were a bit late. So then I took the decision really not to go. And then, of course, people can say that, yeah, you maybe don't attend because you have maybe a high nose or something. That is from another reason. And this reason comes for the fact that injuries can happen. Now, one of the things why injuries, which can help injuries not to happen, is also the holiday. But when you have such a full season like it was this summer, and it will gonna be next summer, we're gonna have 5 main events in 3.5 months in 2019. I'm thinking already. I mean, you have to really manage very good with your schedule.
Yeah. And take care of your tools.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
Okay. Thank you very much for this interview.